2 into bracket x plus 1, close the bracket, over 3 minus 4 is equals to 0. So what's the first step? We do what? Yes. We open the bracket, isn't it?
Yes.
How do you open the bracket? We multiply 2 times what?
X.
2 times x?
2x.
2x plus 2 times 1?
2.
Over?
3.
3 minus?
4.
4 is equals to 0, isn't it?
Yes.
What's the first step? Next step? Yes, Menge? So you find the LCM of the denominator, isn't it?
Yes.
After finding the LCM of the denominator, what's the LCM of 3 and 1?
3.
3. So then you multiply by what?
By
3, again by?
3.
By 3, again by?
3.
By 3, isn't it?
Yes.
So you multiply each digit by 3, right?
Yes.
So 3, yeah?
1.
3, yeah?
1.
2, it's 2x plus 2 minus?
12.
Minus 12 is equals to?
0.
0. So we are finding the unknown value, isn't it?
Yes.
Which is our x, right?
Yes.
Yes. So 2x, 2 minus 12. 2 minus 12?
Negative
10. 2 minus 12, negative?
10.
Negative 10 is equals to?
0.
How can I find the value of x? How do the value of x? How can I find, how can I remove this negative 10? Yes?
You cross it to the other side.
When a negative sign crosses equal sign, it becomes what?
Addition.
It becomes addition, isn't it?
Yes.
So this becomes 2x is equals to, this negative 10, when it crosses equal sign, it becomes?
Plus
10, isn't it?
Yes.
So 0 plus 10?
10.
10, correct. 10. How do you find the value of x?
Over 2.
Over 2. Over
2.
So x is equals to?
5.
X equals to 5, isn't it?
Yes.
Another example about what? Solving before I move to simplification, right?
Yes.
Another example, 7b over 8 minus 2b minus 4 over 3 is equals to 12. So what's the first thing you need to do here? We are finding the value of unknown value, isn't it?
Yes.
In our case, what's our known value there?
B.
B is our known value, right?
Yes.
So what's what do we do here? Yes, Delphine.
Find the LCM.
We find the LCM, isn't it?
Yes.
So what's the LCM of 8 and 3? This is the LCM, 2 here?
4.
2 here?
3.
2 here?
2.
2 here?
3.
2 here?
1.
2 into 3?
3.
3 here?
1.
So what's the LCM? 2 times 2?
4.
Correct. 4 times 2?
8.
8 times 3?
24.
Therefore, we multiply each by?
24.
24 times 24 times?
24.
Yes. Let's now cancel, isn't it?
Yes.
3, 8 here?
1.
8 into 24?
3.
That is 21b minus 7 here 1. 7 into 24?
8.
7 into 24? No, 3 into 24?
8.
8. This is 8 here. Then 8 times 2?
16.
Negative 16. Then negative 8 times negative 4?
Chief, isn't that supposed to be
16b? 8 can go in 24 8 times, isn't it?
Yes.
So this is 16b, right?
Yes.
Minus 8 times negative 4. It becomes what?
Negative.
Minus and minus becomes po?
Positive.
So this becomes negative 8 times negative 4 becomes
positive
32. It's equals to 12 times 24. Multiply. In 1 minute. 1 minute.
28.
Yes?
238.
230?
88.
88, isn't it?
Yes.
Yeah. So 21 minus 16. 21 minus 16. We can use your mental, isn't it?
Yes.
21 minus 16.
5.
5b is plus 32 is equals to?
288.
How can I remove this positive when it crosses equal signs? It becomes?
Minus.
Minus, correct. So this positive, when it crosses equal signs, it becomes minus?
Minus.
So 5b is equals to what? 588 minus 32.
256.
256.
256.
How can I get the value of b?
Over 5.
Over 5. Here 1. B is equals to 5 here? 5 into 25?
5.
5. 5 into 6?
1.
51.
Then it becomes 51. Remainder?
A fifth.
A fifth, isn't it?
Yes.
1 over?
5.
Now, I'm done with solving the problem, isn't it?
Yes.
Next, I want to talk about simplification, isn't it?
Yes.
You want to simplify further. For example, 2 into bracket 3x minus 4y plus 3 into bracket 2x plus 4, right?
Yes.
All over 6 into bracket 2x plus y, close the bracket, 2 into bracket x minus 3y. What the first thing you should do? We are going to simplify further, right?
Yes.
We are going to simplify this expression further. So, the first thing, we expand the
bracket.
Correct. 2 times 3?
6x.
6x minus 2 times 4?
8y.
Plus?
6x.
6x plus?
12.
All over?
12x.
Plus 6y. Plus 2x minus
6y.
Correct. The next step, we collect the like terms. From where? From the numerator. Our numerator is 6x
plus
6x. Plus what?
6x.
Plus 6x minus
8y plus 12.
Correct. So here it becomes
12x
minus 8 plus 12. Minus 8, then plus 12, yes? This now?
And that is
the whole number. This is negative 8y, isn't it?
Yes.
Then plus 12?
12.
12, isn't it?
12.
So I'm collecting like times first, isn't it?
Yes.
We shall simplify further after the, after working. 12x, okay, then plus, minus 8y plus
12.
All over. So I'm done with the denominator, numerator, right?
Yes.
Let me go now to solve the denominator. Like terms, 12 plus, now it will be 12 plus
2x,
which is what?
14x. Uh-huh.
Plus 6y minus 6y.
Zero.
Zero, isn't it?
Yes.
6 take away 6? Zero. So,
wow.
So how can I do here next?
Four.
Yes?
Divide by 2.
I can divide by 2 to simplify, isn't it?
Yes.
Right. So here it will be 2 in the bracket. 6
6x
minus 4y, isn't it?
Plus 6.
Plus 6 all over.
7.
2 in the bracket. 7. 7x, isn't it?
Yes.
So these two cancel this, isn't it?
Yes.
So my final answer becomes 6x minus
4y
plus
6
all over
7.
7x, isn't it?
Yes.
Now this is what you call expression, simplification of the expression, isn't it?
Yes.
Yeah. So I want to leave you a piece of work. Then we'll do it. We'll do it in the course of the day, or tomorrow, isn't it?
Yes.
So write this. What is the value of y in the equation? What is the value of y in the equation? Right?
Yes.
3y. So this expression, find the value of y in the equation. 3y minus 5 all over 4 plus y minus 3 all over 3 is equals to 6, isn't it?
Yes.
That's the first one. I want to just give you two questions before I end my lesson. Number two, what is the value of P plus Q all over R plus S, given that P is equals to 2R, R is equals to Q divided by 5, isn't it?
Yes.
Then Q is equals to 3S, and S is equals to 5, right? So I've given two questions. Now, class, any question from there where you have not understood about solving and simplification of algebraic expression, isn't it?
Yes.
So these terms we're going to solve and simplify if possible, right?
Yes.
So any query, any question? Yes, must.
Yeah.
Yes? Yeah, that's a good question. When we talk about this question, about negative or negative, you're talking about this question or this question, this question?
Yeah.
This question, yes, that's good. When you multiply negative 8, then into bracket 2b minus 4, right?
Yeah.
That's a good question. Negative 8 times 2, it becomes negative 16. But negative and negative changes to positive. When you multiply negative times negative, it becomes positive, isn't it?
Yes.
And positive times negative becomes negative, right?
Yes.
So from today, when you are multiplying negative 8 times negative 4, it becomes positive and not negative. That's a good question. Next question. Just two questions, yes?
Excuse me, sir. And does it apply to every other number, including fractions?
Yes, fraction. Again, that's a good question. Negative 4 times negative 4. This is a fraction, isn't it?
Yes.
This negative and this negative, it cancels, isn't it?
Yes.
So negative and negative becomes positive. So from today, negative and negative becomes what?
Positive.
That's the trick of that question, right?
Yes.
Yes. Is there any question? Is there any question? If there are no any question, you do the what I've given you on the board, then I'll mark the books, isn't it?
Yes.
Thank you very much. Enjoy your day.
You're watching Look Up TV.